pigsty, Scott.
Oh, so it's about this time when you realise your piece of wood's a bit too small. Luckily for me, I'm organised, eh? Eh? Not really, but yeah, sounds good. I'm just going to glue this piece on, you don't need to voice that. You can go now. Well, that's the first lot of pockets using the 30mm cutter. I'll just give this a big clean up here before I get into the next lot. Because there's so many layers, I'm using this printout from my program. It tells me what tool to use when. I think it's very important that you get it right. So use the 30mm cutter. So all that's done, that lot. Now I'm onto a 3mm end mill. Thank you. See that groove and that hole down? Well, the cutter ran through that, and I can see that the cutter's gone through, followed the grain, and the machine's lost its zero, effectively. You can tell that by when you come back to here, that the this normally sits pretty much in the middle of the tool zero, so it's out. And now that I've machined away my zero point on the piece there, I've got a pretty big problem. I have to overcome that, refine my center point. Otherwise, everything's going to misalign. It's a big deal. Damn it! The zero point is right over that pocket there, so I've just used some tape there to help me with that. What I'm going to do is just rehome the machine, then go back to the line that was on, and it should be okay then. So I was able to rehome the machine, found its center, it's back on target again, and I can keep going now. Thank goodness for that. Woo! That's finished. Job done. Cleanup time. Thank you. have to excuse the background noise raining on the outside there. Do I have regrets? Yeah, I regret putting the black in the background. I think it takes away the focus from the center. It's where the eyes were supposed to be drawn to. But anyway, it's all about learning. Listen, I thank you for watching. If you got this far, I'd love to hear you in the comments, and we'll see you on the next video. Take care.